By the end of this tutorial, you're going to have a low-level implementation of a scrolling tilemap, as well as a method to do CSV parsing in order to edit it using tiled. Here is what you need to download: Visual Studio with the C++ package, tiled, and finally, the template. After extracting the zip file containing the template, you can press F5 and hopefully a hideous window is going to pop up. The template is a Visual Studio solution for making simple 2D games with some essential libraries set up, like GLFW, so you know you don't have to worry about making a window appear or getting the input when you run the game. The easiest way to represent a map is to store an array of integers that represent the index of the tile. We could also use a convention for empty tiles, like 0. Fortunately, in tiled, that is exactly what we get: a tile map represented as a CSV file. Better yet, the .tmx file used for saving the file can be parsed into our game directly. Open tiled and create a new map. You can choose the size of the map and the tile size. After clicking OK, save your file. As its location, choose the assets folder from the template and give it a name. You can see that it's saved as a .tmx file. This is what we are going to parse into our game. For the next step, you are going to need a tile set. I will use this free one, but you can use any other tile set you want. Click on the tile set button and add a new tile set. You can choose the image and the tile size. It's a good idea to save it in the assets folder and then you are ready to paint. Now you can select a tile from the tile set and draw it to our map. Delete, erase, you get it. Finally, we need to parse the CSV into our array. That may take some time, feel free to try it, but I have a basic CSV parser from my project, which you can find in the description. Keep in mind it only works for one layer, but I'm sure you can modify it to support multiple layers if you need that. The tile palette we used earlier to draw inside tiled can be loaded into the game as a surface. Just be sure to have it in the assets folder. You should have something like this in the init function before moving on to rendering. Our screen is made out of pixels, so we can copy from the source to the screen, or more generally, to the destination. Surfaces use 1D arrays to represent pixels, but our screen should be 2D. Right? Well, this is a common trick to optimize array traversal. You can read more about that in the article I linked below. We can use this formula to traverse the array, and I'm going to iterate over the process so it's easier to understand. When x reaches the width, y is going to become y plus 1. Next element will be x plus y multiplied by width, meaning x plus 2 multiplied by width if y equals 2. We can see how this formula just maps 1D space to a 2D space, essentially just going from left to right in the one-dimensional space. After you understand how this formula works, you know more or less how you can copy the value of each pixel from the palette and draw it to the corresponding screen pixel. Let's start small and draw just the first tile to the screen. If you run the solution, you should see the tile in the top left corner. To get the indices, we use the formula discussed earlier. Then, using some mats, we get the row and column of the tile from the tile palette. Afterwards, we can draw the tile. Here is a function that draws one tile at the specified coordinates. And now we get a notorious error about access violation, aka we try to write outside the array, or in this instance, outside the screen. We need to partially draw tiles in order not to draw outside the screen. We can start simple by checking if a tile is on screen. If the tile's corners are between 0 and the screen resolution, we can draw the whole thing. Before we run the solution again, we should give our map a position and move it in the opposite direction of our arrow keys. This is necessary to create the illusion of motion, while the camera stays still. These float2 variables are vectors to store the position and the direction we need to take. We can get the input like so. And we also need to modify the game.h class to implement those methods like this. So it doesn't crash now, and you have another great moment to come up with your own solution. But in case you're curious, the logic for one lonely tile at the corner of the screen is quite basic. We can observe how it clamps to the screen resolution when it is off screen, like here. Then you can handle the clipping for every other corner. Finally, the amount we clip also needs to be added to the pixel buffers of the source and destination. If we only add the clipping to the destination buffer, we are going to copy the wrong pixel from the source. So this is how we also need to modify the source buffer in order for the drawing to work properly. In this way we can draw a partial tile to the screen. And now you know how a scrolling tile map works. Here are some optional extra challenges. And yeah, I guess that's it for this tutorial. I hope I sparked your interest to add more mechanics to this project and at some point having your own 2D platformer. By the way, it's totally fine to copy a game so you don't have to do the game design. It's a valid strategy if you want to focus on coding or not. You do you, mate. You can also look into my school project. I had to recreate a game with certain mechanics from an old 2D platformer called Pitfall Man Adventure. I would appreciate if you'd leave a comment below, feedback on the video, on my school project or other mechanics that you'd like an explanation for are welcomed.